Clostridium. The genus Clostridium consists of the gram-positive bacteria. They are obligate, anaerobic, and spore-forming bacilli. The spores resemble a swallowed appearance like spindle. These bacteria are responsible for following three major diseases of human beings, like tetanus, gas gangrene, and food poisoning. Some of the pathogens are Clostridium perfringens, Clostridium tetani, are found normally in the human and animal intestines. Although many species are pathogenic, most are found in water soil. Clostridium tetani is a rod-shaped anaerobic bacterium of the genus Clostridium. It is gram-positive and its appearance on the gram stains resembles looks like tennis rackets and the drumsticks. Clostridium tetani is found as spores in soil and as parasites in the gastrointestinal tract. Clostridium tetani produces a potent biological toxin, that is tetanoplasmin, and it is the causative agent of tetanus. Morphology. It is a gram-positive slender bacillus. It occurs singly and in pairs. It is non-capsulated, motile, by Peritrichus flagella. Peritrichus flagella, it means full body consists of flagella. Now, cultural characteristics. Clostridium tetani is an obligatory anaerobe that grows only in the absence of oxygen at optimum pH of 7.4 and the temperature 37 degrees centigrade. Growth is improved by serum and blood and not by glucose. Growth is extremely fine and translucent, that is semi-transparent. Nutrient agar, blood agar, cooked meat media and lactose yolk media. They are cultured in this media. Nutrient agar. They produce swarming growth in this media. Colonies formed will be round, grayish yellow color, transparent with granular surfaces. Blood agar media. They produce a zone of alpha hemolysis around the colonies in the blood agar medium. Later, it changes to beta hemolysis due to the presence of hemolysin. Hemolysins are lipids and proteins that cause lysis of the red blood cells by destroying their cell membrane. The cooked meat media. The media after incubation become turbid with the gas formation. The meat is not digested but turns to black color during prolonged incubation. Lactose yolk media. No opalescence is produced in this medium. Now, pathogenicity. Clostridium tetani affects a human by causing the disease called tetanus. The spores enter its host through open wounds, lacerations or burns where many cells are dead. This provides the necessary environment for Clostridium tetani to begin to spread to the human body. In the presence of anaerobic conditions, the spores can germinate. This is when the spores produce toxins that are harmful to the human nervous system. The toxin tetanoplasmin travels through the body via nervous system, where its goal is to reach the spinal cord. Here is where the toxin really begins to attack the body. The toxin interferes with the neurotransmitter and thus blocks messages to the brain. This leads to the unwanted muscles contraction, that is spasm. And in bad conditions, individuals can experience severe seizures. The clinical pattern of the generalized tetanus consists of several painful spasms, rigidity of the voluntary muscles. The characteristic symptom of lockjaw involves spasms of the master cell. It is an early symptom which is followed by progressive rigidity, and violent spasms of the trunk and lymph muscles. The spasms of the pharyngeal muscles can difficulty for swallowing. Death usually result from interference with the mechanisms of respiration. Biochemical test. Indole positive, MRVP test negative, nitrate not produced, and gelatin liquefaction test is slow. The nature of toxins. Clostridium tetanus produce two toxins, that is tetanolysis and tetanoplasmin. Tetanolysis function does not certainly known. Tetanoplasmin is a neurotoxin and causes the clinical manifestation of tetanus. Tetanoplasmin is distributed in the blood and lymphatic systems of the host. The toxin acts at several sites within the central nervous system, including peripheral nerve terminals, the spinal cord, and the brain within the sympathetic nerve system. The toxin is taken up into within the nerve axons and transported across synaptic junctions until it reaches the central nervous system, where it is rapidly fixed to the gangliosides at the presynaptic junctions of inhibitory motor nerve endings.